In a bid to combat climate change and its devastating impacts, Vision Group launched the Green Schools project last year. With support from Government of Sweden and the UN Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, the project's main objective is to create awareness on climate change and sustainable use of the environment. Teachers from 10 beneficiary schools in central Uganda were trained on the importance of environment conservation.
This is the 8th training workshop under the Green Schools project. Today we gathered head teachers and coordinating teachers of the program from the central region. The project is funded by the Swedish Embassy and FOA, that is Food and Agricultural Organization. It's a project that we're going to implement in secondary schools. You realize that we're having very big challenges with climate change, and FAO looked out for an implementing partner, and New Vision was found to be a worthy partner to help take this message of climate change into secondary schools.
During the workshop, teachers were reminded on the importance of engaging children in issues of national development, especially climate change, nature conservation, among others.
Students are very imaginative. If you want to scale up anything, take it into a school. So that is why we want to take this message of climate change to the schools. We want to make sure that the students are able to scale this, because if you start within the community, you may not have as much impact, because the students come from communities. So when they go back to their communities, they will be able to scale this up.
We have already destroyed the climate. Now, we need the youth to rebuild the climate. The environment has gone down. And that is what we are discussing, and that's what we are training for. So if we have to make a change, if we have to make a difference, we have to probe the youth. We have to look at our children. We have to target that group. And as we target the children, I'm going to make a sensitive statement, especially the male child. Especially the male child. It's easier for the female. When you talk to the female child, there is a way their mind follows you. Today, when you talk to the male child, it's a different story.
Captain Monda Mutumba, on behalf of the Nakawa RCC, urged Ugandans to embrace the use of renewable energy to reduce environmental degradation.
The issue of renewable energy, because on average in Africa, everybody is eating food which is cooked. Most people are eating food cooked by wood. But wood is very dangerous to the environment. Would suggest that if people go for the use of renewable energy, that is electricity and gas, it would save the environment. It may look expensive in the short run of connecting power in the house, then buying a can and a system for gas, but in the long run, it's cheap.
Teachers who participated in the workshop shared their experiences.
Green Schools campaign, which is basically based on climate change. Climate change issues concern us all, the teacher, the parent, and the child whom I'm going to impart this knowledge to. Would like to appeal to parents out there, when we go home and teach these children the ways we are going to manage the climate, we pray that they can get involved. When it comes to litter, garbage disposal, they should get involved, because if you leave it to a child, they need a push, they need guidance, they need resources which we as a school may not provide.
The first Central Region Green Schools Project training workshop kicked off today at Chitande High School for head teachers and coordination teachers from the 10 beneficiary schools. The project, to be implemented in 150 schools across the country, is a partnership between New Vision, Food and Agriculture Organization, FAO, with funding from the Swedish Embassy. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.